Hello guys, I hope you have been well. So today I want us to go through the tips or the guidelines that you can use when setting up your bonded particle model or creating a bonded particle model in EDEM. Ensure that you have the correct interactions. So that means the bulk material to the equipment material, there is that interaction, the coefficient of restitution, coefficient of rolling friction. So as you can see, and also the coefficient of static friction. As you can see, mine are not active. So when I want to come and start my simulation, the following materials interactions are missing. So they must be defined first. So let's come back here. And then come to steel, we add, say steel like that. And then no further interactions possible, but are we really safe? So let us come back here, then say save. Still rock, we have also to define the interactions between the bulk material itself or any other rock. Okay, so under the bulk material, if you have multiple ones or even itself, you have to define it. So now we click save, then we come back here. The next tip, ensure that you calculate the material properties. As you can see, when we want to come and start our simulation, one or more particle properties has zero mass or moment of inertia. So make sure that you calculate it. How do you do that? You just come to properties and then you use auto calculation. Why do you put auto calculation? So that when you change any dimensions here, it will automatically calculate. So you can either click, if you know you are not going to change anything or alter anything, just click calculate properties like that. But if you change here, let's say you put 20, as you can see, it has not changed. But if you put auto calculation, it changes. So when you change it to 25, maybe to 25, yeah, it changes. So make sure that you put auto calculation. Ensure that you use the correct interaction properties. So for instance, if you put the wrong coefficient of restitution, like let's say you have the coefficient, by default it's 0.5 coefficient of static friction, 0.5 coefficient of rolling friction, 0.01. If you put the wrong ones, when you are generating your bonds, the bonds will not be crushed. The particle will fall through the geometry that you have created, as demonstrated in this clip that I did a while ago, in this simulation that I did. Let's say you have multiple cylinders. You have created your simulation and you have another cylinder that you want to create. But instead of coming and then repositioning it, if it has the same center as your factory, you see I have my factory cylinder. So I can actually copy it. You can either multiple copy or single copy. So I want to single copy it like that. And then I want to change the dimensions so that you can see the difference. So we put 300 like that, and also 300 like that. So now that's my cylinder. But now the issue is I want to put it in, it's physical. I want it to be physical. I don't want it to be virtual. I put physical like that. So once I put physical, once I say save like that, so I come to my simulation, click. So the following materials are missing, but as you can see, it has put by default material is steel. So the thing is, you have to click this down arrow. Even if you have one material, just click it and then you select steel. Why do you have to do this? Maybe you might be having multiple equipment material. Therefore, that's why you have to come and select EDEM. Does not allow you to make such errors. So it has to warn you. So now once you click simulate, now we are okay. Here we have auto time step. So if you come here and then we add our factory. Let's say we add factory like that, and then we say we want it to be static. We put 100 like that, and we say save like that. So come here. Now auto time step here is 100. Usually when you are creating the bonds, you have to make sure that the auto time step is at most 20%. So, but the software itself will auto calculate, it will give you the best time step if you put auto time step. Now, here, it has to be between 2 to 3. So you can put 2.5 R. So these are the number of cells. This is the meshing. Ensure that you set up, use the standard CPU as the engine for the simulation and creating bonding particles. As you can see, there's that explosion. There's that explosion. Even the, some of the particles are flying away from the bonds. So the bonds are irregular and they are not stable. That's because you're using the GPU. As demonstrated, you can see now the length of the bonds, the way they are stretched. So they are not in the correct format. Therefore, we go back. Now we set up, we use the standard engine of the CPU. Do not use the GPU, even though the GPU is faster, for the bonding particle, it's not a good idea, especially when having many, many particles as shown there. Now, as you can see now, the particles have bonded well. There is no explosion. There is no irregular motion of the particles in cluster. You must ensure that you set the correct bonding properties. Otherwise, your particle will explode once the replacement takes place. As you can see, I'm putting a critical stress of 36 MPa and also a critical shear stress of 24 MPa. And this will affect the nature of the bonds. As we'll see, an explosion will take place. Now we go back and we change the critical normal stress and also the critical shear stress to that 6000 pascals and 24000 pascals. And then we see if the normal stiffness per unit area and the shear stiffness per unit area will have an impact on the nature of the bonds that we have created. Actually, the particle is supposed to be bonded well, then kind of bounce off the steel container, bounces off. But let us see what happens. I'm going to fasten this up a bit, yeah, so because it takes a bit of time. Now the particle is coming into contact with the steel container, and as you can see, it starts to collapse by itself. The particles, they are not bonded well. They're starting to collapse. You can assume it's like some sort of a porridge or us. The bonds are extremely weak. That's why you see it's like it's flowing. It's flowing and it should not be like that. So make sure that your BPM properties are correct. They can be determined from experiments or available literature. Now, with the correct bonding properties as shown there, so let us see if our bonds will be created properly or as we prefer. As we prefer. So the bonding has taken place. As you can see, there is no explosion. There are no rogue particles. Even the particle itself, it's bouncing off. As you can see, they are still intact. The cluster is still intact. And that's how it should be. So let us stop the simulation and then we see if there are bonds within the cluster. Yes, as you can see, there are bonds and they are well distributed. Yeah, so ensure that you put the correct bonding properties. In addition, the other sign that can tell you that your bonding properties are not good is when you see that if the cluster, the particles are not together, as you can see, they are kind of spaced. So that means they have not bonded properly. So you have to ensure that they are actually bonded well. This is another behavior that you should expect when your BPM properties are wrong. So as you can see, when the particle has just touched one of the sides, on the fixed, especially the fixed one of the particles, there are two particles. So as you can see, it's breaking, just touching it, it's breaking. That means the bonding properties are not correct. Also, you must ensure that you set up the contact radius well. should just be slightly higher. As you can see, I'm setting up a contact radius of 2. My physical radius is 0.5. Let us see on the simulation. As you can see, the particles have not bonded. They have started exploding and moving in different directions. So this is due to the overlap of the particles. Now let us change it a bit. Let us lower it to 1.5. Let us lower it to 1.5. Yes, the bonding has taken place on some of the particles, but some of them are still not bonded. That's where they are moving in different directions, as you can see. Yes, there are physical bonds there, but they are not strong enough to hold all the particles in the cluster. So let us put it just slightly higher. It's 0.5, therefore I want to put one millimeter. Yes, as you can see, the particles have bonded well. Even when the cluster itself, when it touches the surface, the bottom surface, it bounces up. That means that bonding has taken place and it's uniformly distributed. Okay, the other thing that you must ensure is that when you are putting your cluster data file, the X, Y, and Z axis, the units are exported in meters, while the scaling factor, which is the diameters, they are imported in millimeters. So that when you come to input your physical radius in your simulation for the BPM rock, that the scaling factor will be called in radius, in millimeters, sorry. And also your number of particles should be here. So I have 253 particles in this cluster. For the last guide, you can always use the same DLL file or the custom factory for different particle sizes. You don't need to always go back to C++. As you can see, you have a cluster, particle cluster data of 291 particles. So I want to simulate that particle first, as I have already done the preview of that simulation. So we want to see the number of particles that will be created in the simulation. We want to see the number of particles that will be created. Always remember to set the accelerators standard. So that's my replacement, that's my bonded particle model. Actually, the trick is in the cluster data file. As you can see, we have a total of 291 particles. Those are the ones that have been created, the fraction particles, because they're the ones that are going to form the bond. Now I want to try with another particle. Size of 253. I had already backed it up. So we have a total number of 253 particles in that cluster of different sizes, of course. So we want to paste, and then we confirm that it's 253. Yes, and then we control save. So the trick is behind the particle cluster data file. You don't need to go back to C++ again, create a project. You don't need that. And also you have to call again. Sometimes I was trying, but I found out that I had to call DLL file again so that it registers. As you can see, the grid size has changed. So I have to put it to recommended between two and three, but 2.5 is the ultimate one. So as you can see, even the shape has changed. Remember, this was for 70 millimeters, average of 70 millimeters. So as you can see, you have a total of 253 particles according to the total number of cluster file. So I want to try another one, a larger particle size of 1478 particles as shown. So this, I had done this also a bit earlier. Now for this part, I have now to resize the matter particle, the whole particle, because it was, I think it was around 80 millimeters or it was 160 millimeters in size. So I have now to change to put a bigger metaparticle, that the replacement will take place. Well, if you don't put it slightly larger than the average size, you can see now I have a diameter of 200 millimeters, which is okay. If you don't put it slightly larger, the replacement will not take place well. Also, I have to make sure that my factory is big enough to generate that particle or to create it. That's why I have to resize the size of the factory, because it was smaller. I have to make sure it can accommodate it. Yes, and then I click save, and then let's go to the simulation. Let us go to the simulation. As you can see, I'm using the project API file that we created during our project. So let us see. As you can see, yes, as you can see, the replacement has taken place. It's taken place well. As you can see, you don't even need to confirm the total number of particles. Just go to see if the bonds are there. Yes, the bonds are there. So the trick is the particle cluster data. So make sure it is in the proper format, the correct unit.